I, Chetna Patankar, student manager BIMHRD, feels deeply honored to introduce you amongst us a towering personality, Mr. Biswaroop Mukherjee, HR leader, Grid Solutions, Software Services, HVDC, South Asia region at General Electric. He has worked with leading companies like ABP News Network, Dr. Reddy's Lab, Deloitte and Tata Motors. He is specialized in global mobility and rewards, expatriate management, performance management, talent management. He has been awarded MD's ACES Award, Champions Award in HR, HR Award for Excellent Customer Focus, Star Reward Constellation for Best Team Leader. Now, I would request sir to enrich all the student managers by imparting his leadership experience. Thank you.
Before we get into the topic, who is a star in a corporate world? Every organization has various definitions of a star, a talent in their organization, right? Now, to be a star, what is the most important thing that is required? So every organization, whatever framework they have, if you see, it is a 2x2 or 3x3 matrix where there is a potential and there is a performance. That's how they decide on talent management, and the person with high potential and high performance is told to be as the star. Right? Now, what are the characteristics of this star who has a very high performance and high potential? Going back to basics, if you see, the characteristics of a star is someone who is high in skill and high in will. Am I clear to everyone till now? And please tell me if I am not clear on any, because this is a very, very basic genesis I must tell you. And our next set of discussions will hover around this. So a star in a corporate world is always in any organization, whatever be the mechanism in which they define it, whatever be the behavioral things on which they evaluate, whatever be the performance things on which they evaluate. But traditionally, I'm repeating, a star is someone who is high on potential, high on performance. Clear? Yes? Louder?
Yes, sir.
Great. Now, if this is a star, the star has a trait which is very high on skill, very high on will. This concept is also clear? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Louder?
Yes, sir.
Great. So if a star has high will and high skill, then let us evaluate each one of you today. All of you are doing MBA. All of you are doing MBA. All of you are learning the various concepts of management, trying to get a foothold. So all of you, when you enter the corporate world, you are very low on skill. Skill, almost zero. Just a bit about your whatever you have learned. But practicing is a skill. Now you have knowledge. You are acquiring knowledge. Skill, once you start doing, you will acquire. So when you enter the corporate world, your skill levels are very low. Right? So star, high skill, high will. Now, the will part is something that will help you survive in the beginning, because your skill levels are very low. You have just acquired knowledge and you are acquiring skill, right? Am I making sense? Now, if that is the thing, the only thing you have is to make the skill, the will level high. Right? So, So when you enter into the corporate world, your focus is how can I ensure that I continue to have a high will, which is nothing but a can-do attitude, one. A learning attitude, two. Right? These are two things which will make you a high will person in the corporate world. Right? So, your first few years, the focus should be on learning and doing, a can-do attitude. Okay, this challenge has come to me, I will get it done. I am open to any challenge. I am willing to dirty my hands and get down to brass tacks. I do not have airs around me that this is my job, this is not my job. Everything is there. I need to learn the trade. I need to increase my skill level. So, if you have the high willingness, slowly, if you have the can-do attitude, if you have the learning attitude, if you are willing to dirty your hands, you slowly build your skills. Once you start building your skills, then you are in the reckoning for the star. Right? So first few years of your career, it is very important that you focus on your learning, your ability to grow in the organization. And hence, it is more important that you showcase a behavior in which you are adapt. You are easy to adapt. You are easy. You can learn easily. You can do things differently. You can experiment different things. I think these are something which really are important in the beginning of your career. And acquire the skills, because all of you are acquiring knowledge now. You have no skill. Except for some of the guys who are experienced, who have joined from after lateral. But your skill levels are low. You have to acquire those skills, skill sets. Hence, my focus is that all of you must focus on a can-do attitude. I think that is something most important. And I think these are things that you learn over a period of time. Once you go into corporate world, that there are a lot of things which you haven't perceived that you need to do when you were doing your MBA. So those are the being open to those. I think that is also an important aspect. Right. So I will actually stop here and actually. Take your questions on certain things on what we spoke now. How you have been able to understand what I told? Does it make sense to you? Do you have any doubts?
Sir, you said about high skill and high will. So when we enter in the corporate world, skill is also little most important part, right? And so what's your take on it? Like, skill is more important or will is more important?
Both are important. Because it is not only the technical knowledge or it is the functional knowledge that is required. You also require behavioral abilities to transform that into meaningful work and transform them into meaningful business results. And hence, it is not only the IQ, it is the EQ as well, which is required to be successful in the corporate world. And hence, both the skill and the will. So if I know a lot of things, let me give a very simple example, plain example. I know a lot of things, but I shirk from doing work. I don't put in extra hours. I will not be successful. I will not be a star for the organization.
So EQ is more important than IQ.
Both are important. If you do not have functional depth, so that's why I said it's a 2x2 matrix. It's both the X axis, Y axis and the X axis, both are important. It is not one thing. if you are functionally competent and behaviorally not, willingness is not there, then it is not cutting ice with the corporate. The same way, if you have a can-do attitude, but you are functionally not solid, in the beginning of your career, it is expected that you would not know. But after 5 years experience, if you are functionally not aware of what you are working on, then that's also an impediment for you to grow.
So people focus more on IQ rather than EQ. You know, when you are at workplace, they are more focused on their IQ, that they possess more knowledge rather than focusing on
That's a myth, as I said. You know, because once you get into the corporate world, you realize it is both which is required. You know, your functional dexterity, your behavioral maturity, both are required to gain success in a corporate world. And that's why it is very important to ensure that, you know, you acquire both right from the very beginning. And that's why I said a can-do attitude, an ability to learn, an ability to change, an ability to adapt. I think these are very important parameters once you get in the corporate world. So first 5 years, guys, everyone, please try to acquire knowledge. Please try to learn as much, do as much. Do not look at, you know, because I have been also an MBA student and I have been also going through the same. I wish I have been more learned when I joined, but I have learned through the hard way, I've learned through experience. But trust me, all of you should focus on learning in the first 5 years as much as possible. Doesn't matter, you know, someone is getting 5,000 more, someone is getting 10,000 more here and there, this brand, that brand, doesn't matter. Whatever you are doing, learn the trade, learn what you are doing. Have the attitude to understand and grasp as much of your area. I think that is something which is very important. And hence I said, IQ, EQ, both required. You just cannot, a guy who's very good in his functional domain, but does not have the ability to work with people, doesn't have the ability to lead teams, will never be able to become a leader.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hi.
I wanted to ask something regarding the job switch. Like, it's like, earlier, the people used to join a company and retire in the same organization, while today people shift jobs, switch jobs very frequently. So, what's your take on this? And adding to it, adding to her question, like multi-skilling is also considered. Like they say, first you have to expertise in one field and then go multi-skilling. So, and on the other hand, there's an argument where they say, if you are a multi-skilled person, you have higher chances of getting into a better place.
Okay. So, see, we are currently living in a world of choice. You know, 20 years back, this economic scenario of the country and today are very different. And it will be even more different 20 years later. I do not know how 20 years later, how the scenario will be. But I hope it will be even better and we will be not a developing but a developed nation. So, today we are living in a world of choice. Today we are living in a place where it is globally connected. Today we are having the options, right? So my personal take, again, as I said, I am a professional. These are my personal views. There's nothing wrong or right. But my personal take is, whatever your aspirations are, if you are really, first of all, that's why I said, first of all, understand what you have got into. Understand what does it mean. Understand what are the various facets of that job that you are doing. Then decide. Depending on whatever your aspiration. So I may want to be the CHRO. I'm talking about me. I want to become the chief human resource officer of an organization 5 years down the line. I want to become an entrepreneur in HR 5 years down the line. I want to leave everything and start teaching. I want to leave. Don't want to do anything. I just want to go back to my village and start farming. Those are personal aspirations that you have in life. So once you have learned where you are, once you have understood the corporate world, once you have gathered sufficient understanding of the place where you belong, then decide how you want to traverse that journey. And in that journey, decide that what are the milestones you want to take to achieve whatever destination you want to go. So, like in a road, a milestone provides you that you are 30 kilometers from here, 60 kilometers from here. So make your milestone so that you know you are on the same track where you want to go, which is your destination. So there is nothing on right or wrong answer. It is each to his own. At the end of the day, what is important is, are you marketable? Is there five people who want to bet on you? Is there five businessmen who want to pay you money, whatever you want? Do you have the skill sets to do that? Right? So as you grow and as your milestones, you know, you cross milestones, it boils down to what value you bring to the table. And that's why I was my first and most important knowledge sharing with you is create first, learn to create value. And once you know that, yes, I have the ability to create value, how you choose to give the value, whom you choose to give the value, is something that you decide. And hence, it doesn't matter you are working in one organization for 30 years or three organizations for 10 years or 10 organizations for 3 years. That is, if that is possible, you continue to get value, your aspirations continue to get met, your professional satisfaction continues to happen, your choice. And then as you grow up, your, you know, personal things also happen. Someone wants to settle abroad, someone wants to remain with family, someone is not mobile, someone wants a balance. Those aspects happen. Those also you'll have to take into consideration. So as I said, do not plan 30 years from now. You do not know 30 years from now how you will happen, what will happen. Plan 5 years, understand where, first of all, you know, learn as much when you are in college, get into a good job, whatever you, you know, so I will come to that part also, that once you get into a job, learn, be, you know, someone who is open for any assignment. No errors around you. And then once you decipher the code, decipher where you are, then decide on based on your, as I said, you know, and but the most important thing is you have to understand when you join organizations, you are in the business of building value, creating value for customers, for organization, for yourself. Right? So if you are creating value for the organization, if you are creating value, they will give you value. So how you become a valuable person? I think slowly the world is moving towards you have to create your own brand, and then you know, organizations will change. But again, as I said, each to his own. These are my thought processes, and this is how I feel.
Sir, I do have one question that for us students, our first corporate experience is our internship. Mm-hmm. So while doing our internship, what we experience is we were restricted to some limit up to which we can't go. And there were lots of many questions which were remain unanswered by the management as they don't have that much time. And our time in a corporate was also limited. So I'm asking that when a fresher joins a company, then also the same happens with him. Second question is, in GE Power, what is the culture you follow there for interns and new freshers?
So internship and jobs are very different. And that's completely, most of you will find it different. Maybe 5-10% of the companies take internships seriously. So if any of you have worked in organizations where after the internship, they have a very thorough evaluation process, then they go for PPO for some, do not go for PPO for some. Those are the companies probably you still may have seen some bit of closeness to work ambience. Internship traditionally and typically is seen as a part of the curriculum. I get a student, I get my dirty work done. So I will give some analysis, I will give some Excel sheet, that's how mostly, and when I'm saying, pardon me, I'm not actually referring to the entire 100% of the ecosystem. I am saying that mostly this is how it is done. There are companies, there are corporates which really take internship very seriously. Those are different. So that's why I'm saying in those cases you will get, but largely mid-sized and not companies who are gathering more into getting more in HR savvy as days progress. They are seen as someone who's, you know, come here to do some work. So keeping that in mind, I think internship is a good insight. You get to know how corporates work, but do not base your judgment, your opinion based on these 2 months you spent. My personal suggestion is, this is just the beginning. You have seen a trailer. The movie may be good or bad. You actually, once you go through the whole movie, then you actually know. So do not base your judgments too much. There are corporates, as I said, there are corporates which really take internship very seriously, and they make the interns go through. So luckily, I have been part of such organizations. So be it my in my previous stint in Tata Motors, General Electric, I have just joined. I have joined 30 days. So I will not comment too much on it because I am also learning the organization. But what I know is they also have a very clearly defined internship program. And also they evaluate very seriously. And then they offer PPOs to candidates who they think that are suitable to their culture and their you know, cultural fit and all that. Similar, Tata Motors also had a very, very effective campus internship program, which used to call SIP, Summer Internship Program, and there also evaluation was done. But I would say that it's just one part of the story, and it's more for you for a learning perspective, but the real experience may be completely different and will be very different.
So my question is, what is the actual term VUCA means in the organization, how it may...
What I'm trying to tell you is, what it does is, as we are globally connected, as we become connected, you know, so when you are globally connected, what happens is, you know, something happens in US, there are implications in India. Something happens in Nigeria, there are implications in India. Something happens in Middle East, there is implication in India, right? So we are globally connected. When you are globally connected, you are doing trade globally. There will be lots of ups and downs, and that's what VUCA basically what it says is basically you will go in an uncharted territory, right? And when you are going in an uncharted territory, what you will have to do is you will have to be agile, you will have to learn fast, right? You have to be nimble-footed. So if I am doing in certain way and then the market requires me to change in certain way, I have to be quick to change the way I play the game. I have to be fast to anticipate. I have to be the first one, fast to anticipate and first one to change and make the move. So these are things that organizations have to continuously do. And today organizations have also learned that, and everyone is gearing up because it's a question of survival, right? If you do not adapt, you will not survive. So organizations are surviving. You know, that's how they are doing, they're adapting. Yes, it's painful, but that's how it is.
Question related to market. So now the privatization of the company will really help the company to go future ahead. Means nowadays we can hear that the public sector companies like National Thermal Power Corporation and all are going into losses. So means the talks are going on that it would go privatization in next coming years, in 4-5 years or all. So will it make profit and make some changes in the means coming years, and will it give a competence to for the companies like General Electric and all?
So this is more towards the economy and all. I'm not a master, but I'll still comment since you have asked me the question. My belief is that, see, these are all policy decisions of the government of India on how they want to do business in certain infra and power related aspects. So efficiency levels definitely are perceived to be better than government when it goes into private players, or when they are divested in the market. So those are thought processes, and they have their own pluses and minuses for the economy, because there is also certain things which when a government does, there are certain controls, certain regulations which are more followed. So there are pros and cons in, you know, private and public undertakings. Time will tell how it works. And
so that means the companies which are already there in the private sector, so will it give a boom to that companies, or
Depends on the industry, sector, segment. There are a lot of economics involved. A macroeconomic, microeconomic, you know, indicators. There are a lot of things involved. I cannot tell you upfront that this is this. If this we do, then I would have been, you know, chief economist of the country. But on a that was on a lighter note. But on a serious note, I think there are a lot of macro and microeconomic indicators which decide a lot of aspects of doing business, right? And those are to be evaluated to be correctly, you know, mapped. So there, and there are views on each. You know, some people have their views on various aspects of economy, you know, the right way.
So my question is related to skill and will you talk about. So there is a condition where the requirement is of payroll person. And the requirement is like 3 years of experience. But what I have experienced during my internship is that the person who was having 3 years of experience, he was not knowing the difference between salary account and the current account and the saving account. And for the similar requirement, the fresher is not allowed because he is not having the relevant experience or the 3 years of experience. So what is your take on that? Because if the requirement is of 3 years experience, what I understood about this is that person is having a relevant skill and the understanding of the particular domain. But if he or she is not having a knowledge of basic skills, then how the skill is taking a part over there? And even the will, the fresh, who is almost freshers like us, who are starving for a work opportunity, so the will also is in high intensity part in us. So what's your take on that?
Yeah. So I will tell you something which you will hear in corporates as you go even more. So it does not matter how many years of experience you have. It does not matter how many years of experience you have. It matters the experience. What matters is the experience in those years. Right? So please understand this term, what I said. It does not matter how many years of experience you have. It matters the experience in those years. So if you have done the same job for 10 years and someone has done different things in those 10 years, the person who has done different things is more highly skilled. Right? That person is more highly skilled because that person has seen the same thing from various facets. Right? Regarding the will part, there is no substitute to positive attitude. As I said, willingness to learn, willingness to change, learning, adaptive in learning. So a great attitude is always a great substitute. And that's why I always said that when you are joining from the campuses, when you are fresher from campus, if you have a great attitude, if you have a learning, you are high on will, a great attitude is a perfect substitute for skill when you are in the beginning. But that will not be true as you progress in your career. To be a star, as I said, you need to have a skill and will both. But in the beginning of your career, you need to have a great attitude to deliver. And as I told you, through answer specific to your question, that experience of 0 to 3 years, personally, and this is my personal view, I would any day want to work with 1 year experience and great attitude rather than 6 years experience, bad attitude. Because that experience is not worthy for me if there is a bad attitude. I cannot deliver on my outcomes. Does it make sense?
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
So I just thought that, you know, it is important because I could have also made a PPT and given you a great lecture. But I thought these are more important things to know, learn, and I can share my experience. And hence, I am enjoying this conversation. I hope you as well. And please feel free to reach out to me as well. You know, I am on Twitter, LinkedIn. You can connect with me as well.
Thank you, sir. As said by you, that the ability to communicate condense and complicated issues into relevant and cogent set of message and present them skillfully can be differentiator for your success in corporate world. Also, It's very necessary for us to understand the skill level and willingness to accomplish a specific task.